Welcome to another edition of the Doubleheader. I'm Hari Sreenivasan with Mark Shields and David Brooks. We're here to talk about the sport of politics and the politics of sport. First, on the political front, so we see these debate bumps, we see these different kind of things in sort of local polls and battleground states. Sometimes they're different from national polls. How does one make sense of it? Because the next morning, you think, okay, was this regarding the debates? Was this regarding just the candidate? And why does it matter if it's in Ohio versus if it's in the rest of the country? It's very confusing.
So I spend 18 hours a day looking at the polls. And you know what I
you
learned?
You and Nate Silver at the New York
Times,
yes.
I know. So you know what I learned? That Obama has a slight lead.
Okay.
That's it. That is the only thing I've learned over the past 6 months.
Okay.
So my advice, don't pay attention to the polls. Understand that Obama has a slight lead.
And just
that's
go to
all.
Vote. Whatever your
that's
decision is,
it.
Go to vote anyway.
And so people who are driving themselves crazy by this or that poll, getting mad at this poll, Gallup's way out of line, it's all wrong.
It's all
Obama
wrong.
Has a slight lead. That's all
that's
you
about
to.
It.
Yeah, there's a couple of caveats, all right? Admonitions, warnings, however you want to put it. First thing is, Real Clear Politics, which is a very popular site for a lot of people, and I really like the people who write there and work there, Carl Cannon and others, they do something that I think is just bad judgment. They take all the polls and put them together.
Okay.
Now, you wouldn't make wine that way. You wouldn't make a stew that way.
It would taste horrible.
It would, because you're putting in bad polls that are done by automatic, I mean, polls that don't have a human person involved in the process at all.
Right.
It's just a, you know, I don't think are the same. I can lie as I'm putting in a, what's your income? 400,000.
Right.
I have a PhD. You know, I mean, you can just, you know, you can just embellish and all the rest of it. So I think that's fine. The other thing is you want to be absolutely sure that they have at least 25%, at least 20, but probably ideally 25% of their respondents being on cell phones.
Mm.
If you see them doing a poll that doesn't have cell phones, I mean, we're talking about an increasingly large demographic in this country, especially young people who don't have landlines.
Right.
So I
the
agree.
The cord cutters.
I'm sorry?
The cord cutters.
The cord
people
cutters.
Who cut the landline
oh,
cord
good.
Off.
That's
yes.
Good.
Yeah.
Like
it's been
cutters.
Around for a little while, but that's
yeah,
right.
I know.
No, he made it up.
He's good. He's
cable
good.
Cutters, too?
Yes,
yeah, cable.
Cable
yeah, they're
cutters.
Cutting cable instead of.
Cut,
right.
Yeah, okay. So I think that's part of it. And the other thing is people are focusing on the states so much. I don't think that they're really separable. I think that we rise and fall as a national tide. If you fall in 5 points, you fall in 5 points. If you're rising 5 points, when Romney rose after the first debate, and he did, and even though Democrats don't want to concede that in many cases, he rose across the board. Now, I mean, some places it didn't make him competitive,
right?
But it just doesn't happen in Oshkosh and not happen in Asheville.
Okay, all right. Finally, the sport of politics. Now the politics of sport. What the hell? The Yankees, the Tigers.
Oh.
Wow.
Wow.
I mean, the Tigers, that's a nice feel-good story, right? But
yeah. No, the Yankees is the feel-good story.
Schadenfreude.
Yeah, that's the best story.
Taking
said by a Mets fan. Yes.
And I like Derek Jeter. And I actually feel sorry for A-Rod.
Ooh.
I do feel sorry for him.
Do you really?
I do. I mean, the guy.
This is a man of infinite empathy.
Yeah, he's a down-on-his-luck kind of guy, isn't he?
Yeah.
He's a Hall of Famer who's getting benched in the postseason.
But look at his performance.
Yeah.
Shouldn't he be benched?
I mean, he should have benched the whole team.
Yeah.
I mean Robinson Cano. I mean, right. they stopped. I mean, baseball really is a sport when you're hot, you're hot. And the Tigers got hot at the right time. I agree with you. It is a great story. Detroit needs a good story.
And
it's a city that needs a lift. I mean, when I don't have a dog in the fight, I always want to root for the city that needs the most, is going to help the most. And I think that's the case with Detroit. And I agree. I'm sorry that Derek Jeter got hurt. He's exempt from my anti-Yankee fervor, I mean, the rest of
my
feeling sorry.
This is a very biased cast, just so you know.
It is.
We do
it
not have a
we
Yankees fan.
We are an unrepresentative sample.
Yeah. Yes, we're not.
We may
be
cable cutters. I don't know.
We had cell phones, and nobody asked us. So, anyway, it's a completely biased section of the NewsHour. Just know that going out.
But I'm feeling compassionately conservative for the millionaires, the people making $28 million.
My kind of people.
All right.
By the way, did you watch the Al Smith interview? Speaking of funny jokes.
Yeah. How'd that go?
Ron, I don't know if people, if you haven't seen it, Google over to Al Smith dinner. Very funny jokes.
So do you think Al?
I did not think it was.
So let's.
I did not think
this might be.
I thought Romney had a couple of great jokes. He had one really good joke. See, the problem is the test is can they be self-deprecating. neither one of them was. Yeah, okay? And but Romney had a very good joke about Andrew Cuomo. Andrew Cuomo was there, governor, gets good reviews, but he's talking about running for president. Here's a guy, one-term governor, whose father was a governor.
Yeah.
He's going to run for president. Those are his credentials. Not bad. Okay.
All right, so we will link to that. I think it's probably on the web somewhere. But do you actually believe that, you know, compare that to the physical confrontation when those guys got so close last week to each other that they could have sort of swung at each other, and you could feel the tension in the air. You could feel both of them had a very strong dislike for the other guy.
Yeah.
So when they dress up in tux and tails and go to something like this in the middle of the campaign, and believe it.
Which is the real.
There is no real.
Yeah.
Politicians are capable of gigantic and completely sincere acts of insincerity. the real doesn't enter into the equation here.
I think Tuesday night came more real.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Closer to real. I mean, they were like two roosters, for God's sake.
Yeah.
You know, hey, you wanna? Me, macho.
Right.
Me, macho me.
Right, huh? Right,
you wanna
strut?
You wanna, you know.
You want a piece of this?
It really was. Yeah, let's go. You wanna rumble? Let's go out in the parking lot. I mean, it was just, I'm sorry. It was really unbecoming.
And you've become unbecoming as well by watching the doubleheader and giving us your time. Thank you so much for joining Mark Shields, David Brooks, myself, Hari Sreenivasan. Stay with us.